Tonight we have Corina, who's had an amazing experience out of Kelowna, British Columbia here back in July 31st, 2003 with a good friend of hers. I guess you would say it was frightening. Some of the results that came out of the sighting and or the experience, very dramatic medical conditions, so forth. So anyways, I'd like to welcome Corina and...
Hi, Brian. How are you?
Good. And yourself?
Good, thank you.
Great.
Good.
Well, I guess you had yourself more than an experience. I mean, you've had a lot of experiences, you know, over the years, but this year on July 31st, 2003 seemed to take the cake. And wow, I mean, I'm blown away from, you know, some of the things that came out of it.
July 31st, a girlfriend of mine had come up from Abbotsford to visit for a few days, and to make the long story short, we were looking at some rentals on the internet, and it was around midnight. It was, yeah, about 5 minutes to midnight, and she was leaving the next morning, and she said to me, just quite suddenly, why don't we go stargazing? And I looked at her, and I said, well, I'm quite tired. It's very late. I said, you know, can't we do that the next time you're up? Oh, no. She said, come on. She said, let's just go. And I thought, well, okay, what the heck, we'll go. But I didn't really know where to go stargazing because I just recently moved myself to Kelowna, and I didn't know where to go to do any good stargazing. So we got into the car at about midnight. We left my apartment building, and I found myself driving along one of the back roads to go to Vernon.
Okay.
And I had never gone up that area before, so I didn't really know what was out there. We started driving, it's a Thursday night, you know, midnight, and I thought, geez, there's a lot of traffic, and I just finished saying to her as we were driving, you know, I don't think we're going to be able to get any stargazing done on this road. I said, look at all the traffic. Then I don't know what happened, but, I mean, it seemed like within 3 minutes of saying this, there was absolutely nothing. Not one set of headlights. There was no moon that night that I can remember. There were no street lights. I mean, this is out in the country beside the landfill, and there's just nothing there. So I said, oh, well, okay, all of a sudden it's quiet and it seems very dark out here.
Right.
Why don't we just pull off on the side of the road? So I pulled over to the side of the road, and she got out of her side with the binoculars and started looking up right away at the stars. And because of the time of year it was and the recent sightings that they'd had with bears and cougars, I had brought my 1.5 million candlelight. So anyway, I plugged the light in and I got out of the car, and right away she said to me, so it was within 2 minutes of being out of the car, if that, she said, geez, you know, there's three lights up here in a triangular formation moving together. It looks like three stars. And she said, well, stars don't move like that. I said, of course not. I said, no, it must be, you know, a plane or something that you're seeing. She said, no, no. She said, it's three stars moving in a triangular formation. And then right away she said, oh, wait a minute. She said, it just changed. I said, what do you mean it changed? She said, well, it's a green, neon, green-colored thing that's up there, she said.
Right.
And I said, well, what does it look like? She said, well, it looks like an oval, like an egg shape. Oh, she says, no, it looks circular. But the color remains like a bright neon green.
Right, right.
At that point, around that point, what I did is I turned on my light, looking down ahead of us, down the road to the left, and about 45 feet in front of us, there were some sets of eyeballs looking at us.
Right.
One was by himself, away from the other four. I don't know what happened, but it was almost like it was a telepathic thing. It was like he knew what I was thinking. I knew what they were thinking. I panicked. My first thought was, it's got to be animals or something.
Right.
And then when reality checked in, I went, oh, my God. And I remember frantically trying to get back closer to the vehicle to open my car door, but it was like moving through quicksand and in slow motion. And every time I would try and grab at my door handle, it was like I had no strength in my hand, and it would slip off the door handle. and I would be getting more and more panicky. I mean, I could barely breathe by this time. I was trying to scream at my friend to get back in the vehicle, mm-hmm. but my voice would hardly come out. The next thing I know, we're both scrambling into the vehicle. We're sitting down. By this time, we're pretty freaked out. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm trying to get the vehicle started. It won't start. But yet, all the lights are going on and off, and things are just going crazy.